In tonight's cover story, medical answers from alligators. Remember Chance the Snapper and the Florida gator catcher who rescued him in less than 24 hours? It turns out Frank Robb has a biomedical degree, and we visited him in Florida where he checks in on Chance and hand feeds him. Well, Frank works tirelessly to see how alligators can enhance human health. Surprisingly, he's found more than a few ways. But how does he get close enough to test the alligators? It turns out, the same way he nabbed Chance, by calling them.
For the untrained ear, this is alligator speak, a technique Frank Robb has been mastering since he was a child. As a teen, Frank set out on his first alligator catch.
It all started with gator wrangling with your uncle.
Yeah, I think the first time I ever went out was with my uncle in the 10-foot John boat to get a gator that was in a pond, and we caught a 11-foot gator out of a 10-foot boat.
Were you scared?
No, it's one of those things that you grow up being around these animals and not necessarily knowing what you can get away with, but knowing to have a genuine respect for them.
It was a powerful lesson passed down by this man.
When I jumped this one and managed to get my muddy hands in her mouth.
Rocking the family resemblance, Uncle Bill taught Frank the family trade.
I felt a sense of responsibility, but at the same time, Frank had to hold his own too.
And that he did, making a name for himself with Florida's Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission.
It's kind of meandered itself into a career of sorts, I reckon, yeah.
He took us to the place that first set him on the path.
When you came out here as a kid, is this some of the first places that you were observing gator behavior?
Oh yeah, we'd come out here and watch gators from Mr. Fleckinger's property. This time of the year, the winter time, here in Florida, you'll see the gators almost always on the north bank, out of that north cold wind and in the best southern exposure with the sun.
He just seems to have that conservation ethic. He always has. He started working with me when he was in high school, and I mean, he is just extraordinary.
Anybody that thinks catching alligators for a living is easy, they're strongly mistaken. It's very mentally taxing, and it's very physically taxing all the time.
Yet when Chicago called Florida for advice dealing with its alligator problem, and the state recommended Frank Robb, he did not hesitate. He jumped on a plane to help nab Chance the Snapper from the Humboldt Park Lagoon.
Whenever you can save someone's life, it's a very warm, fuzzy feeling.
That was Frank's goal, to save Chance. And in less than one day, jackpot.
I was wearing my boots, and I waded out there real quick because it was all solid and pretty shallow. And you've seen Chance, he's a pretty thick little fella. He was trying to swim off, and I was able to reach down there in that water and grab a front arm and a back arm and stuck his tail between my legs.
So how did he so quickly find the elusive gator that had been the talk of the town and the subject of intensive searches for a little more than a week? Frank spoke his language and called him.
Chance didn't talk back to me, of course, but he responded to the vocals and came out of where he was hiding and gave me a chance to catch him. I'm gonna try to talk to him.
The alligator vocalization began at the St. Augustine Alligator Farm Zoological Park with fellow crocodile specialist group member, Jen Bruggen.
Breaking out of the nest, they're talking to each other, and then when they find themselves in danger, they'll release the vocalization to call mom or even sometimes dad over to help them out.
Working with an audio team, Frank meticulously records each sound in these tiny crocodilians. Then he masters the call.
That's how I work every day. It's a tool I have in my toolbox, so I'll use that in order to get the animal to present himself in order to be caught. There's so many different types of calls. There's distress calls, there's happy calls, there's sad calls, there's I'm angry at the world calls. Hey, there you are, you're new to this pond, let me say hello to you kind of calls. So what he's saying, howdy, how you all doing?
And it doesn't just work on the babies.
Uncle Bill, there's a giant alligator snapper in there. That's a daggum giant.
We ventured out to see the more than 1,000 crocodilians at St. Augustine.
Look at them, they're all happy and smiling. Look, got a whole army laying up here in the bank, taking a break.
How could you not love an animal that smiles all the time?
Frank called the big guys. Within seconds, they came. were amazed as it happened repeatedly. Gators resting in an enclosure hear his call. Suddenly, there are 6 gators at his feet.
Vast majority, it'll make them pretty much jump right in your lap.
His strategy,
American alligator,
based in science, is helping further scientific research. Alligators don't succumb to viruses or bacteria. They rarely get cancer. And they have the same endocrine system as humans.
The American alligator's endocrine system is 99.9% the same as ours, which is kind of bizarre to think about that, but yeah, it's true.
We can learn so much from them.
No doubt. They may eventually be the cure for cancer and AIDS and everything else.
But to aid that study, Frank needs to protect the species and promote the possibilities. And just by chance, a star alligator from Chicago.
I couldn't ask more for him to be here in a place where he'll never have any worries ever again. You wait, you give it a few years, he's gonna be a boss.
Now living peacefully at St. Augustine, is shining light on his work.
Yeah, you're gonna make me cry, but yeah, it's very special, very special.
Chance has grown 4 inches since coming to St. Augustine. He's a little more than 4 feet now. Frank says he could be a 12-foot alligator when he's full grown. Tomorrow night, we venture outside the gator farm and go onto Kennedy Space Center property to go gator catching in the wild with Frank. See him in action and see the impact on human health as they collect blood and tissue samples sent to labs around the world. The hunt and the ultimate goal of better health. That's tomorrow night.
4 inches. Wow, he's doing well.
Yeah, what'd you call him? The alligator whisperer?
Yeah, he is a gator whisperer. Yeah.
If you're looking for gators, you want to be with Gator Robb. That's for
right.
Sure.